Most people in life are looking for how do I make a life worth living and retirement worth having. When we're seated outside on a beautiful evening, even though it's raining, we're able to see God in everything around us. We see the birds playing in the water. We see the children sort of screaming about being all wet. And we see the parents running to get in and out of, well, the rain. And isn't it sort of funny that people are afraid to get wet today? We have lots of opportunities in the world to see God around us. And sometimes we forget that God makes it rain. Isn't that interesting that we can forget how God brings the storms to our life to remind us of Him every day? When we don't listen to God, when we don't hear the Lord, when we use our own countenance, we often end up in the wrong space with a bore. And openly, that's on your life. You chose that way. You chose to do that thing. You chose to be with that person. You chose to let go of everything and everyone without thinking about God. In life, we have moments of time to speak the truth about the world, and the truth is God is in everything, including COVID. And that's something that people don't want to hear. They don't want to hear that God is cleaning house. They don't want to hear that God is not pleased with us at all. They don't want to hear that Christians have failed the Lord, and when we have guns across the world, we're not thinking about God. We do think about self-defense. We certainly think about how to protect ourselves from the liars of the land who want to steal our houses, steal our property, steal our opportunities, steal our medical rights, steal our privacy rights, and just piss all over us because they feel like it. But what we have to say to them and what we have to remind them of is that someday they will stand before God. And when they stand before the Lord, they will have to decide, did they do everything that God had asked them to, or did they lie, steal, and hide from the Lord? You see, you can't really hide from God. Isn't that the funny thing? People will do selfish things all day long. They'll steal things, they'll betray people, they'll ruin lives, and then they'll think that God is with them somehow. God is not with them. God is actually against that kind of behavior. And God says so quite clearly in many stories of the old ways in the Bible. And in the Quran, that is a different version of that Bible. But openly, people don't usually take the time to read those things. They don't take the time to memorize passages. They don't take the time to look in the book of John about the Good Shepherd and how God leads us through, well, safe waters and green pastures. But in life, sometimes we don't pick the right pasture to play in. And in life, sometimes we don't understand what God wants us to do until sometimes we have to really walk it through. And when we walk it through, we have to walk through our life from now until the end of our life. Who's going to be there for us? And who's going to look after us? And who's going to take care of us? And what kids are going to care for us? And how do we know who's right for us if we're too busy being slighted by the ones who say they love us? You see, those who say they love us don't necessarily prove they love us. And those who prove they love us don't necessarily say they love us. And openly, that's sort of the game that people play, that they don't want to talk about love very often. They don't want to hear that love is important in the world, and they don't want to play lovingly with their neighbors. They don't want to play caringly for the people around them. They want to be in control, in power, and literally what it puts them in is a lot of, well, not power. You see, God can take the power away. My father was a powerful man until his late years, and then he lost his power. He lost his ADLs. He couldn't do things for himself anymore, but thankfully he still kept some of his mind. So he was able to be read to, and he was able to be fed, and he was able to do some of those things by himself, but for the most part, he had to have a lot of help. And I believe it was God's somewhat of a punishment to him for the hardness he had been on his life and the difficulties he had given his wife and the challenges that he had provided to his children. But at the same time, he matured over time, and he was a marvelous man and a friend of mine. And openly, I can talk about my late father that way like any young son can. But what I miss the most about my dad is how much he loved us, how much he cared for us, how much he showed us, how much he celebrated us, how much he loved family time, how much he loved events with us all around him, and how he loved to just be sort of in power but not in power, quietly there but just enjoying his grandchildren. Even my son was considered a grandson of him, and I valued that about my dad. Even in his funeral, my spouse and my son were acknowledged, not the same as my siblings' kids, but about the same, and that's what people do today. In life, we have moments of time to speak the truth of love, and my father loved my family. He enjoyed our international Thanksgivings with him and his wife and some of my siblings, and then our international friends from Japan. And we did those things regularly. I miss my late spouse, but what am I supposed to do? People do things, and they go places, and they move things, and openly that's what happens. But when you pick the wrong makeup, when you pick a runner-up, it's not the same. There is no runner-up in God's house. You see, all people are valuable to the Lord. And these Black Lives Matter campaigns are marvelous, but they teach an entitlement that's not marvelous. They don't remind people of the heritage and the hatred and the triumphs and the, abuses and yet the successes that people brought out of darkness into light. You see, Martin Luther King was an amazing man, and he has incredible quotes all across the world. But if we forget who he was, if we don't remember who Rosa Parks is, if we don't pay attention to the number crunchers who helped the satellites and the astronauts come home safely, then we don't remember who we are today. Because even if I'm not of color, I can celebrate what's been done to provide for our families, to move our nation forward, and to celebrate that right now we have the first female Black or Asian, if you will, Indian, if you will, it doesn't really matter, she's of color, in the White House. And that's really good. We also have a lot of people across the world that are suffering from COVID, but we are not responsible for that suffering. We are also not liable for bringing them the, replenishment drug to put their lives back in order. You see, they lived a lifetime in those countries. They lived a lifetime not raising their own people up. They lived a lifetime dreaming of other worlds a wild away across the sea and didn't play correctly in their own homes, in their own cities, in their own meccas, in their own, stone huts, if you will. Because if you want to grow a society, then you work your ass off like Americans did. You see, we had a wild, wild west at one time, and we've grown all the way beyond living in loincloths to being pretty sophisticated, pretty incredible as a nation, pretty amazing as a land, and pretty marvelous for food and other things that we would like to have in our hands. But the truth is, in life, we must celebrate how far we've come. But we don't have to depict that we are the saviors of the world, because God sent his son for that. And if they don't know that, that's not on our life. We've had plenty of evangelists go abroad, and many died in that stead. But the truth is, in life, when we talk about God, the best example is how we behave. And if we have loved our children really well, then they know God. If we have promised the world to someone, then they don't know God. If we have failed to teach people the truth of heritage, the truth of history, the truth of our flag, the truth of our forefathers and foremothers, then we have failed the world. You see, every nation around the world has a choice to raise their own people up and to keep improving their cities and improving their technology and improving their transportation and improving. But if they want to pour all that across the world and not do the right thing and puddle jump out of their world, then they failed their own cities. They failed their own people, and we are not liable for that at all. And it is a pity. But America brought itself forward out of the love, the honor, the regard, the cherishment of our world. And while many people across the land, across the world, might relish the idea of becoming American, it is an honor and a privilege to be one. And when we have sovereign citizen-oriented police who want to piss all over you with those words as if you don't have rights, then we have to get rid of them and we have to defund them. And when God speaks it's time to defund the police, it means it's time to defund the police. It means you have failed yourself because you lied, you stole, and you cheated people like me and others out of our property, out of our paperwork, out of our loves of our lives, out of our photographs, out of our histories, out of everything, even our wives. And you have lied to yourself about your right to do that. We have a National Guard that is marvelous. We have an amazing military that we need greatly. And what we're going to do is start to protect our nation from the liars in the woods, the liars in the hoods, and the liars who want to steal and cheat you and me out of our rights. Human rights, dignity of rights, medical rights, privacy rights, technology rights, and superior success rights, meaning the right to engage in business, are our right. We have the right to pursue life, liberty, and happiness as long as we're not interfering with other people's lives and other people's rights. And that is our lesson today.